Hi, today we're going to be looking at a new app, or relatively new, by Dev47 Apps. They've made DroidCam, now they've made DroidCam OBS. Let's see how we can put this to use in OBS. Welcome to Empowered. Thank you for joining me today. It's a pleasure having you as always. Thank you for all the new subscribers, and it's been such an incredible journey over the last few weeks. The channel has grown a little bit over the last few weeks, and I thank you for all the new people that are coming on board. Now, what is Empowered all about? At the Harvest of Ready, or Empowered, we want to equip the church, whether it's in your spiritual life, your media ministry, or if you're even wondering if there is even a God, and we're going to be covering all of those in the future. But right now we're going to be looking at DroidCam OBS. It's a really good little app. It's in beta at the moment, so we'll look how we can install it and get it working inside OBS on whatever operating system you are running. Okay, here we go. So here we go. This is the developer's page, DroidCam OBS, and don't get confused with DroidCam. It's a different app. This one will plug directly into OBS. So it's made up of two parts mainly: the app on your phone and the plugin for OBS. Now with OBS, you may now also need to install another driver, the USB driver for Android, so you can connect it directly via USB. So what do we need to do? Well, on the phone, let's have a look at it here. Let's bring it up on the screen. You need to install, there we go, the DroidCam OBS Early Access Edition. So you install it on your phone, and it's good to go. Let's open it up and have a look at it. So there we are, it's up and running. But you also need to on the computer, you need to install the plugins. So let's go into the plugins down here. You download the necessary plugins from here, particularly, so from the Dev Apps Store, you know, dev47apps.com OBS. You've got Windows, Linux, and Mac. So you just run the installers for each one of those particular operating systems, and you will be all ready to go in OBS. So that's all good. Just make sure you are running version 24 or 25 of OBS, and it does not support Streamlabs. So you've got the plugin installed, you've got the app installed. Now you need to, if you want to connect it via a USB cable, you need to enable debugging mode on your phone. Okay, so this is a very, very important step. Without this, it will not communicate properly. You can install the driver like I showed you before from the website, but if you're not in debugging mode, it's not going to help you. So let's go to settings. Okay. So to go to the settings on your phone settings, okay, let's turn it on first. Enable it, go to settings, go to about phone and tap the build number 7 times. In this case, it's the MUI version. Oh, you no need, you're already a developer. So that means I'm already in developer mode. You don't need to do anything. So simply, you go to your about phone, click on the build number, in my case it's the MUI version, and if you see this, you know that you are already in developer mode. The ADB driver will work perfectly fine. Okay, so on to the next part. So you install the plugin, and then you install the driver for Android, and now we're ready to go into OBS. So let's have a look at that. Okay, so let's have a look at that. Let's get another instance of OBS running. So I've got a new screen up here. As you can see, we've got OBS running. Now what we want to do in this new scene is we want to add the DroidCam OBS source. And there it is there on the list. So we simply click on that, and we select the name, it's fine. Now, if you plugged in the USB cable, you can just click refresh. and your device is there. If you can't see it, you'll just have to use Wi-Fi. If you need some help with that, please drop me a line. I'll see what I can do, okay? But I'm going to use the USB mode, which is the Redmi 6 one here. And I am going to deactivate when not showing. Okay, so that. And then I'm going to activate it. And there we go. You'll see my smiling face coming up on the screen. Cancel. Uh-huh. There we go. Kitty. Smile. So there we go. Okay. So we've got it there. To make it resize, we just transferred and fit to screen. So there we have it. We have the DroidCam working, the DroidCam OBS working quite quickly. It didn't take that long, did it? So here we go. There we go. So what did we need? We need the app on the phone, and we needed to download the plugin for OBS from the website. We needed to install the ADB driver for Windows. Linux, I didn't go over that quickly, but Linux is quite easy. You just go to the terminal and type in DNF for Fedora DNF install ADB, and that will install the Android tools, and that will get that up and running. You go to, for Windows, you go down and download the driver that I showed you. For Mac, apparently it's all up and running, so you don't have to do anything. So there's a few things that you need to do to get USB working. Now, I reached out to the developer, and he was really, really quick in responding. So thank you so much. And he answered the mission. So I asked him first, how long has this been in development for? Okay, so the OBS app and plugin came in about January and February of this year, 2020. And where he works on them in addition to his DroidCam app, and various other clients and all. Maybe 3 months part-time has gone into this particular OBS app. So, great. Okay, what features do you expect to be available in the first release? Multiple video formats up to 1080p. So the first release will come out and it will be at 1080p. Okay, he did mention in his comments that he was gonna go up to 4K. And he also wants to have camera controls, so white balance and exposure and configurable from the computer. Both iOS and Android. So that means you don't need to go to the phone to change your settings. So you're about to change that will be so awesome. You know, so you're about to, yeah, think about it. You know, you're about to change the contrast, the details and all that sort of thing directly in OBS, no matter what platform you're using. So fantastic. So yeah, when does he expect to get a release? Well, he's got no hard confirmation. Only once the app ratings and stability are consistently good, then it can be considered released. Until then, he'll continue to get improved and rapidly based on feedback. Okay, you said you're working on 1080p and 4K. Do you expect much latency over those connections? 1080p, no, but it depends on the device, he says. Okay, 4K he hasn't tested, and it's one of his biggest hurdles. Okay, so what advice would you get the best possible latency? And of course, he says latency is the biggest challenge of anything, and the app will be optimized for minimum latency at the cost of some quality. So maybe, so in order to get the latency, you have to sacrifice some things accordingly. So here's some tips what you can do, okay? The app has an FPS boost. Try that, see if that helps. Connect over USB rather than Wi-Fi, and unless the router is in the same room, and turn the screen off once connected. And the bit rates he recommends, 2 megabytes, for 720 and 4 megabytes for 1080. So there you have it. So I hope you enjoy that quick little tutorial. And you can find me on The Harvest Is Ready, and you can follow me along there with some spiritual feeding. And you can also subscribe to this channel. You know, like, comment, and subscribe. Please do. It helps a lot. And I do like to see the feedback. So please comment down below. Until next time, God bless.